Introduction. The chapter develops cybersecurity and the possible cyber attacks that the charging points of the fleet's electric vehicles may have, their consequences and the measures to be adopted to prevent and avoid them. Index. Cybersecurity of charging points. Electric vehicle charging stations. Types of cyber attacks that the charging station can suffer. Cybersecurity recommendations. Cybersecurity recommendations, VSOC. Communications. Physical access. The QR code scam at Tesla charging points. Implications for fleet management. Subscribe to the fleet management channel. Your subscription is a great support to continue making new videos. Subscribe. 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 Communications. Communications through the WAN network with the charging point operators must be carried out implementing the use of digital signatures. In this way, several security principles are guaranteed, such as that the message was sent by a known entity, authentication, that the message was really sent by who it claims to be, non-repudiation, and that the message was not altered by third parties, integrity. Additionally, the information must be encrypted using TLS, transport layer security, to guarantee the confidentiality of the transmitted information. If it is detected that a message has been modified, said message should be rejected. In turn, the charging station must allow the parties with which it communicates to verify the integrity of its messages. The device must be able to detect packet replay attacks and reject such packets. To detect packet repetition, the use of a counter or the sending of an authentication nonce can be used. Correct management of system events is also recommended so that system security events are stored safely on the computer, avoiding its possible alteration by malicious users. These events may include but are not limited to user activities, credential changes, possible signs of attack attempts, and changes and updates. The events will be sent to a SIEM security information and event management for processing.
Learned about our fleet management consulting and training services. Reduce costs and optimize fleet management activities. We electrify your fleet of vehicles. We carry out the electrification plan until its implementation, known as
physical accesses. Detection and recording of any attempt to physically manipulate the charging station. To do this, it is advisable to have sensors that detect any opening or physical manipulation of the devices that make up the station. Deployment of a surveillance system to have evidence of the physical manipulation that the devices have suffered by an attacker. Furthermore, it is advisable to properly control logical access so that users, their roles and credentials are correctly managed. Support updating of credentials and cryptographic keys. Support the use of session time limit and make it configurable. Device passwords must be stored with SALT and using hashing mechanisms to guarantee the security of the credentials. Additionally, a strong password policy will be followed to avoid possible dictionary or brute force attacks. To authenticate the electric vehicle user in the terminal, a token that makes use of the challenge response mechanism should be used. This token will be identified by a unique UID, universally unique identifier. Physical accesses. Firmware updates will need to be deployed to the device so that the device must support remote firmware update. Before installing any update, it must be reviewed to check for any modifications or possible malware. Before installing any update, you must verify that the source is the official provider or manufacturer. It is recommended that periodic security reviews be carried out on the devices, so that firmware updates include the solution to possible discovered vulnerabilities. Physical accesses. It is recommended that when deploying the charging station, a bastion process be followed so that all services that are not strictly necessary for operation are disabled. Services that have any type of known vulnerability are disabled. Only the communication protocols necessary for the operation of the equipment are used. Direct remote accesses are only allowed through the WAN interface of the local controller. Ports and interfaces that are not necessary must be disabled, in particular any debug port on the device. Default accounts such as guest or anonymous must be deleted. Additionally, any unnecessary provider user accounts will also be disabled. Remote access to administrator accounts should not be allowed. The QR code scam at Tesla charging points. It is an easy scam to execute by cybercriminals, and it can also get numerous victims who may not be used to using this type of chargers because they have a vehicle of another brand, as is the case of the complainant who owns a Renault, or they are doing it for the first time. The scam is then developed according to the testimony of a victim. According to him, one Sunday he went to Plaza Mayor in Madrid with his vehicle to the chargers that Tesla has there. He did not know if his vehicle was compatible with these devices, but since he saw a free spot, numbered 2A, he decided to go over and check if there was any type of information about it. At that moment, at the top of the pole, it was noticed that next to the connector there was a QR code along with a message that said that it was necessary to scan it with the mobile camera to obtain precisely information on how to carry out the recharging process. What he did was scan it, and on his mobile phone, the browser opened, and what apparently was the official Tesla page, very well designed so that anyone would fall into it, the victim claims. Subsequently, they were referred to a site where they were urged to download an app from the official stores, either Android or Apple, depending on the phone the person had. Our protagonist, with an Android, was taken to the Play Store, and once there, he is placed to download an application called Tesla Supercharger. The process continues without raising suspicions, because even in the user ratings, it appears that this app with the Tesla logo has more than 4 stars, out of a total rating of 5. When he downloaded it and ran it, he saw as soon as he opened it that a map appeared with the location of the Tesla charging points, something that also happens in the legitimate app. It also asks the interested party to provide their data as well as credit card information to use as a means of payment and to be able to charge them for any recharges they make. The affected person comments that he already had previous experience with other payment gateways and that he never had any type of problem making online transactions by providing his debit card information, so he had no major qualms about providing his banking information. However, here he began to see that something was not working well, because even though he entered all the data correctly, the app denied him his card. What did he do then? Give the details of what he calls his good card. In that case, the sign-up process was completed without a problem, and the next thing he did was go back to the app and check how it worked. Until he realized that he was in a fake application, which did not take him to any specific menu for recharging and only showed him the map that was seen at the beginning. The point is that he did not trust what was happening to him, and with good judgment, what he did was access the website of his bank to block the card, arguing that it had been stolen. Since he couldn't get the matter out of his mind, that same day at night, he was checking his email, the one with the address he had provided during registration, and saw that in the spam folder there was a welcome message to a streaming service called Pulsler that gave a free 5-day trial period, followed by recurring monthly charges of €39. He also found a link to access the site using the username and password that he generated when registering in the app, and there he found his data, including the card data. He inquired to find out how he could unsubscribe from the service, but saw that it could only be done by chat in English or French. He tried it and explained to his interlocutors that he was requesting leave and that he had reported them. 10 minutes later, he received an email confirming the cancellation of the service. Our protagonist wanted to know more about the Pulsler site, discovering that it is a type of sophisticated scam, and that in the last 2 months it had claimed numerous victims, not only through the use of QR on chargers, but also at payment points in the Blue Zone and even in schools to enroll children in extracurricular activities. Despite the inconveniences that this person suffered, it must be said that he acted impeccably, doing everything that should be done in these cases in which he has already fallen into the trap. In addition, sharing your experience will also help others not go through the same situation. One of the ways to protect against these threats can be solutions like Sandblast Mobile. which is designed to defend corporate devices against advanced mobile attacks. In fact, it can protect against possible apps that you have downloaded, attacks that come from an intruder who checks who connects to a Wi-Fi network, malicious links that come to you via SMS. Implications for fleet management. Location of fleet charging points. The electric vehicles in the fleet must be recharged at our facilities to ensure the use of the vehicles. It is not recommended to recharge at third-party, public, etc. charging points, because they may not be in service or occupied, and therefore we would have serious problems using our vehicles to provide the service. Another reason, as previously developed, is that in public or third-party charging points, we do not have cybersecurity control, and therefore there is a risk of suffering a cyber attack, which is why it is not recommended to use them. In our facilities, we control the charging of vehicles, and we control which workers use the chargers. For these reasons, it is recommended to have charging points in our facilities. Main consequence for a fleet of vehicles. Charging stations can be subject to both physical and remote attacks. Physical threats include attacks that range from unauthorized access to internal components of stations, which allows attackers to modify equipment, steal sensitive information, or override security features, to much more complex attacks, which may not always be possible. Be carried out. Some of these threats can fully compromise the infrastructure through spoofing attacks, performing a denial of service, DOS, or manipulations with firmware updates. There are several consequences of a cyber attack on the charging point for a fleet of electric vehicles, but the most important is that the charging point becomes unusable and the vehicles in the fleet cannot be charged, and therefore the service cannot be provided. And that they demand a ransom from us in cryptocurrencies to be able to use our own charging points again. In addition to the cybersecurity of the charging points, there is the cybersecurity of the vehicle itself due to the connectivity that all modern vehicles have. Another serious consequence is the manipulation of the vehicle itself, which is very dangerous if carried out when it is being used, which can cause an accident or the vehicle cannot be used. Create a protocol for using the chargers. A protocol must be created that develops how to use the charger, what it can and cannot do, improper use, etc. The workers in charge of using the chargers must be designated. It is not recommended that just any worker use the charger. Chargers can suffer sabotage from the workers themselves to obtain information or render the charger unusable. And they usually occur during strikes. From my experience, when I worked as a fleet manager in the company that managed street cleaning in Madrid, when a new collective agreement was being negotiated, there was a strike, and the vehicles suffered damage such as punctured wheels or broken windows that made the vehicle unusable. In a fleet of electric vehicles with the chargers disabled, the vehicles can no longer be used. Strikes are usually common in public service fleets such as garbage collection or street cleaning. It is recommended to install the charging points in a safe place and install security cameras, as is done in a fleet of internal combustion vehicles to control refueling and prevent fuel theft. Acquisition of charging points. Before purchasing charging points, you must know what the security is against possible cyber attacks and the vulnerabilities of the charger itself. Also, technical support from the charger company as well as firmware updates. Implement a VSOC in the fleet. It is recommended to implement a VSOC in addition to all the measures that have been developed previously. Hire a managed service provider MSP expert in charger cybersecurity. It is recommended to have a qualified worker in charge of the cybersecurity of the chargers, the cybersecurity of the vehicles, or hire an external company MSP to do it. It is better to have this annual cost than to suffer a cyber attack with the serious consequences it has for the fleet.